few years, the greeting will not be as long as what Dr. John Sun was talking about. Guests of the head table, Deputy Consul General, consuls, foreign dignitaries, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, really a pleasure for me to be here today. And I want to congratulate the hosting organization led by Mr. Tong Weijun for organizing such a wonderful and meaningful summit during this challenging time in our globe. And also I want to thank the previous speaker, Dr. John Sun, for your insightful knowledge in globalization, in diversity, and also in multiculturalism. This actually is my ministry promoting, and thank you for being a champion in promoting global harmony and global peace. I do have a greeting from our Premier, Dr. McKinsey, and may I have the pleasure of bringing the greeting to you. On behalf of the Government of Ontario, I extend warm greetings to delegates attending the second North American Chinese World Summit, NACWS. Toronto is a place of gathering, a world-class city where people from every part of the world came together to exchange ideas, form partnerships, and do business. A strong financial investment sector is critical to a healthy economy, and I am delighted that summit organizers have chosen this dynamic and diverse city as the location for their in-depth examination of current economic challenges and opportunities. Entrepreneurs, investors, financial institutions, and government representatives from North America and China will converge on Toronto to network, brainstorm, and plan for the future. I am confident that NACWS will be informative and productive for everyone in attendance. Please accept my best wishes. Dr. McKinsey, Premier, Ontario.
John Patterson 博士呢，不但是一位备受尊敬的作家及时评家，他同时也是合规风险管理、新巴塞尔资本协议的执行及金融服务业争议仲裁等几大领域的权威。作为加拿大帝国商业银行资金和风险管理部的高级副总裁，John Patterson 博士致力于推行一套全新的基于风险的资本制度。他是2008年中国国际风险大会会议的主席。John
Patterson，unfortunately, I'm going to bring everything down to earth and talk about the economy. And I've made my adjustment to the economic world by retiring. And I tell you what a liberating way it is to go and see the world with new eyes. After 40 years of being an economist with international organizations, banks, and a university professor. And I think the other advantage you get from having taken steps like that is a feeling of independence, a chance to review the world as you see it, rather than looking at the world through a frame that is given to you by whatever job you have. I'd also like to make a comment about Mr. Fang Sun's talk. Globalization is incredibly important. If globalization fails, everybody is poor. If globalization fails, people in China don't have jobs. If globalization fails, American consumers are even worse off. Canada, as an exporter to the world of raw materials, would be in worse shape. So the globalization issue is an incredibly complex issue. And where I am particularly concerned, and just want to make this bridge to the discussion earlier, is that it isn't clear to me that there are institutional frameworks in place, nor legal systems, nor information, in order to manage globalization.